hide through my disguise.
And no one can deny,
baby, that I'm the one whose love is no surprise.
And he can't tell you no lie.
But there's a secret I've been hiding, I can't keep it no more.
A Miranda bow, it lies atop a mound of snow, high in the hills where the cold winds blow. It's the biscuit of Zaza Miranda bow. Come on, yippee! Let's go! Yippee! The biscuit of Zaza Miranda bow. Our bags are packed and ready to go. Let's start the van and be gone. Start the van and be gone now. Our bags are all packed and we're ready to go. Let's start the van and be gone. Come on, let's go! The biscuit of Zaza Miranda.
What's that you say? We can't leave yet today. You've just got an errand to run.
I just have to stop at the bank.
You just have to stop at the bank? Well, if you insist, I suppose, we can deal with a minor delay.
Deal with a minor delay.
Say, Archibald, who made this biscuit anyway?
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Sir James McNabb of the Guild of Dough. He made the biscuit so long ago, and the people they traveled to see it glow
on the mountain of Zaza Miranda Bow.
Come on, hooray. Let's go!
Hey,
the biscuit of Zaza Miranda.
Oh, what is it now? This isn't the way.
I just need to stop for some goldfish food.
You don't even have a goldfish.
No, but I was thinking of getting one, and I wouldn't want him to go hungry. Anybody need anything?
Maybe a venti half-calf vanilla hazelnut latte? Hold the whipped cream. And maybe one of those little chocolate-covered graham crackers?
So, Archie, what's so great about this biscuit, anyway?
Well, if you really want to know, the biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow was lost to the world many years ago until my great-uncle Archibald stubbed his toe on the frozen dough of
the biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow.
Come on!
Please, let's go!
No tears!
The biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow.
No, not again! It's just not fair!
Map.
A what?
A map.
A what?
A map.
Oh, a map.
The biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow. The biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow.
The joy.
The thrill.
sausage gravy.
Huh. I might have made a wrong turn.
Back to the van! Back to the van! It isn't too late! Let's go! So high in the hills where the cold winds blow,
the biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow!
We're almost there! Oh, isn't this great?
Who needs to take a potty break?
Me!
I'm here!
No!
The biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow, it lies in half a mound of snow. High in the hills where the cold winds blow, the biscuit of Zaza Miranda Bow!
Performing the traditional Argentinian ballad, The Dance of the Cucumber, in its original Spanish. Bob the Tomato will translate.
Miren al pepino.
Watch the cucumber. See how he moves. Like a lion chasing a mouse.
Miren al pepino.
Watch the cucumber.
Es suave es movimiento.
Oh, how smooth his motion.
Es como
like butter
en un chango
on a
pelón.
Bald monkey.
Miren al pepino.
Watch the cucumber.
Los vegetales.
All the vegetables.
Enviden a su amigo.
Envy their friend.
Como él quieren
wishing
bailar.
To dance as he.
Pepino bailarín.
Dancing cucumber.
Pepino bailarín.
Dancing cucumber.
Pepino bailarín.
Dancing cucumber.
Baila, baila
dance,
ya.
Dance, yeah.
Miren el tomate.
Look at the tomato.
No es triste.
Isn't it sad?
Él no puede bailar.
He can't dance.
Pobre tomate.
Poor tomato.
Él desearía poder bailar como el pepino.
He wishes he could dance like the cucumber.
Libre y suavemente.
Free and smooth.
Pero no puede danzar.
But he can't. Okay, stop the music. What do you mean I can't dance? I can dance. Well, what about Uncle Louie's polka party? Didn't you see me dancing at Uncle Louie's polka party?
No comprendo.
No comprendo? I'll show you no comprendo.
Mom, Dad, look over here. Get a picture of me next to the cucumber in authentic Argentinian garb!
Okay, Junior, but we better hurry. I think the dwarves have your mother confused with someone else. Say peas!
Peas!
Escuchen al pepino.
Listen to the cucumber.
Oigan su voz
here
fuerte.
His strong voice.
Como un león.
Like a lion.
Listo a devorar.
About to eat.
Escuchen al pepino.
Listen to the cucumber.
Qué dulce es su
how
canto.
Sweet his voice.
Qué sorbo
the
su
breath
garganta.
From his throat parece is like a chorus
trina.
Of little birdies.
Escuchen al
listen
pepino.
To the cucumber.
Los
all
vegetales.
The vegetables.
Inviden a su amigo
their friend. Wishing to
cantar.
Sing as he.
Pepino
singing
cantador.
Cucumber.
Pepino
singing
cantador.
Cucumber.
Pepino
singing
cantador.
Cucumber.
Canta,
sing,
canta
sing,
ya.
Yeah.
Escuchen el tomate.
Listen to the tomato.
No es triste.
Isn't it sad?
Él no puede cantar.
He can't sing.
Pobre tomate.
Poor tomato.
Él desearía poder cantar.
He wishes he could sing.
Fuerte y dulce como el pepino.
Strong and sweet like the cucumber.
Pero no puede.
But he can't.
Ni siquiera dar un sorbido.
Can't even whistle. All right, that's it, señor. Come over here and let me sing you a song.
Adios, amigos.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Larry sing.
Bob is really angry. I hope he doesn't catch me. It's so hard to run with the sombrero on my head.
And now it's time for Helpful Humanitarian Songs with Mr. Lunt, the part of the show where Mr. Lunt comes out and sings a helpful humanitarian song.
Well, he's a mangy old pet. If you saw him, I bet you'd walk the other way. So sad and alone, with his hair overgrown, like a stinky old toupee. But doggies have feelings, and doggies need love. And doggies like those deep-fried treats that come from up above. Oh, donuts! for Penny. Please give a glaze to make him smile. Thank you, ma'am. Poor troubled beast, won't you at least comfort him a while? Sir, can you spare a donut for Penny? Please help my doggy friend. Thank you, kind sir. A honey dip would really help his broken heart to mend. His broken heart to mend. Well, just look at this pup. He's brightening up. Oh, he's looking not so weak. Oh, Penny, his outlook was grim till you gave pastries to him. Oh, look, he wants to speak. Oh, doggies have feelings, and doggies need love. That's a boy, and doggies like sweet doughy treats that come from a papa.
Maybe you shouldn't have any more donuts.
No,
don't give him any more. They make him crazy. Like Jerry Lewis. No more donuts for the dog. Oh man, this is a terrible idea.
This has been Helpful Humanitarian Songs with Mr. Lunt. Tune in next time to hear Mr. Lunt say,
don't give donuts to dogs!
Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. We join Larry as he follows the tragic saga of Barbara Manatee in the daytime drama Endangered Love.
Barbara Manatee, you are the one for me. Bent from up above, you are the one I love.
Please don't cry, Barbara. You're a nice manatee. You've been so good to me. But I must go into the world and do noble things for the good of all. And you can't come because you don't speak French. Au revoir.
But if you leave, Bill, who will take me to the ball? Who's going to take me to the ball, Bill? I have a new dress and shoes, a new manatee lipstick. Who will take me to the ball?
I'll take you to the ball, Barbara Manatee.
Please don't go.
I must.
Don't go.
I must.
Don't.
Must.
Don't.
Must.
Barbara Manatee.
Manatee.
You are the one for me.
One for me.
Sent from up above.
Things for the good of all.
Yes, but first, Bill, will you take me to the ball? Oh, Bill, will you take me to the ball?
I can't dance.
You can't?
No.
I must go.
Please don't go.
I must.
Don't go.
I must.
Don't.
Must.
Don't. Don't.
Must.
Barbara Manatee.
Manatee.
You are.
what are you doing?
Jeff, watching a little TV, Bob.
Well, maybe you should read a book.
Yeah, okay.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Bill say,
Barbara, I've learned to dance.
Oh, Bill.
And now it's time for Bedtime Songs with Junior, the part of the show when Junior gets tucked into his warm, comfy bed and is sung a bedtime song.
Good night, good night. I'll tuck you in, good night. I'll kiss your cheek, soon you will sleep. Now close your eyes, good night.
Mom?
Yes, Junior?
Can I have my bear?
Your bear?
My bear, right there, with brown and fuzzy hair. I love him so, and you must know I feel so much to spare. I moan and groan and cry and weep, my tears would drown my counting sheep to have to sleep. Oh, please, Mom, please don't make me sleep with all my fuzzy bear. Thanks.
Good night, good night. The lights are off, good night. I'll fluff your sheets, soon you will sleep. Now close your eyes, good night.
Mom?
Hmm?
Can I have my cat?
Your cat?
My cat, yes, that. He's soft and cute and fat. I love him so, and you must know my heart would fall down flat. It would yearn and ache, and then it'd break. My tears would soak a birthday cake. The earth would quake. Oh, please, Mom, please, I'd lie awake without my chubby cat!
Good night, good night. It's really late.
Mommy, oh, don't go. I need my white-tailed doe. I love her so, and you must know my grief would overflow.
Good night, good night. I'll tuck you in, good night.
My horse, my dog, my prehistoric frog. I love him so, and you must know.
Close your eyes, good night.
My crow, my goose.
Good night,
my monkey and our moose.
Good night,
good night,
good night.
My monkey and our cow. My poor leg squid, my poo-poo. I love them all, I really do. I cry and weep when no one has my broken heart. With never meant to be. Don't make me sleep without my bear.
Good night, Junior.
Good night.
This has been Bedtime Songs with Junior. Tune in next time to hear Junior say,
can I have a drink of water?
Our curtain opens as Larry, having just finished his morning bath, is searching for his hairbrush. Having no success, Larry cries out,
oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where, 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 oh, where is my hairbrush?
Having heard his cry, Pa Grape enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Pa regains his composure and reports.
I think I saw a hairbrush back there.
Back there is my hairbrush. Back there is my hairbrush. Back there, oh, where, back there, oh, where, back there is my hairbrush.
Having heard his joyous proclamation, Junior Asparagus enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Junior regains his composure and comments,
why do you need a hairbrush? You don't have any hair!
Larry is taken aback. The thought never occurred to him. No hair? What will this mean? What will become of him? What will become of his hairbrush? Larry wonders,
no hair for my hairbrush. No hair for my hairbrush. No hair, no hair, no where, no hair, no hair, no hair, no where, back there, no hair for my hairbrush.
Having heard his wonderings, Bob the Tomato enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in the towel, Bob regains his composure and confesses,
Larry, that old hairbrush of yours, well, you never use it, you don't really need it, so, well, I'm sorry, I didn't know, but I gave it to the peach. Because he's got hair.
Feeling a deep sense of loss, Larry stumbles back and laments.
Not fair, oh my hairbrush. Not fair, my poor hairbrush. Not fair, not fair, no hair, not fair, no wear, no hair, not fair, not fair, not fair. My little hairbrush.
Having heard his lament, the Peach enters the scene. Himself in a towel, both Larry and the Peach are shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of each other. But recognizing Larry's generosity, the Peach is thankful.
Thanks for the hairbrush.
Yes, good has been done here. The Peach exits the scene. Larry smiles, but still feeling an emotional attachment for the hairbrush, calls out,
"Take care of my hairbrush. Take care, oh my hairbrush. Take care, don't dare not care. Take care, nice hair, no fair. Take care of my hairbrush."
The end. It's time for Love Songs with Mr. Lunt, the part of the show where Mr. Lunt comes out and sings a love song.
He said to her, "I'd like a cheeseburger, and I might like a milkshake as well." She said to him, "I can't give you either," and he said, "Isn't this Burger Bell?" She said, "Yes, it is, but we're closed now. But we open tomorrow at 10. He said, "I am extremely hungry, but I guess I can wait until then. 'Cause you're his cheeseburger, his yummy cheeseburger. He'll wait for you. Till sunrise, he may have dozed off once or twice. When he spotted a billboard for Denny's, bacon and eggs for half price. How could he resist such an offer? He really needed something to munch. Cheeseburger, please do not get.
Time for the latest dance craze with Jean-Claude and Philippe, the part of the show where Jean-Claude and Philippe come out and teach us the latest dance craze.
Hello, boys and girls. I am Jean-Claude P.
And I am Philippe.
Get ready to learn the latest dance craze sweeping the nation.
So, Jean-Claude, where do we start?
After you, Philippe. After you.
We're a couple of shipper little French peas.
Most of the veggies totally agree.
And when we're feeling really, really happy, we
do the Hopperina. You may ask yourself, what is the Hopperina?
And how do I do the Hopperina? What am I missing out on? Will people like me if I fail to grasp it? Should I just eat a bonbon and go back to bed?
That's totally normal. Calm down and we will show you. You don't need much to do the Hopperina.
It won't take too much time to explain.
Fuzzy slippers on your feet.
Bunny ears upon your brain.
Do the Hopperina. Okay, now that we've got on bunny slippers and ears, what we're going to do is take a hop to the left.
Left!
Beautiful! Now, take a hop to the right.
Right!
Try bien! You've got it! Hop to the left.
We do the Hopperina.
Then hop to the right.
I love the Hopperina.
Back to the left.
And do it once again.
Ooh, Hopperina. That's it! Amazing! You have mastered the dance so quickly!
Let's keep going!
Hop to the left.
We do the Hopperina.
Then hop to the right.
Hold it! Stop hop, the music!
Hop, what hop, are you doing? Hop to the left, hop to the right, hop to the left, hop to the right again. This isn't a dance, it's hopscotch!
That's Hopperina.
A dance has to be more involved. You need more steps, more room for interpretation.
We have bunny ears.
You think it's so easy? Let's see you do it.
All right, then.
No. You need the ears and feet. Ultra ball, this is serious asparagus.
I believe you'd probably agree with us.
The best way to not be a sourpuss. Do the Hopperina. Hop to the left.
He does the Hopperina.
He hops to the right.
Trying not to complain.
Back to the left.
And do it once again.
Hey, Hopperina.
This is actually quite fun. Let's see. I hop to the left.
Hoppy Hopperina.
Then hop to the right.
I love the Hopperina.
Back to the left.
I'll do it once again. Hey, Hopperina. Oh, this is quite fun.
Can I have my ears back?
Okay, that's enough. Thank you.
This is very pleasant.
This has been the latest dance craze with Jean-Claude and Philippe. Tune in next time to hear Jean-Claude say,
I am embarrassed for you.
And now it's time for Ukulele Karaoke with Bob, the part of the show where Bob comes out and sings an ukulele karaoke.
What's going on?
You are doing the ukulele karaoke, no?
No, I'm on a break. This is the Pirates.
We are busy with the rest of the show.
But I don't even know the song.
Your lyrics, monsieur. Bring in the props.
But wait,
Waikiki! Your island breeze, monsieur!
Hold on a sec. I'm totally unprepared to do a solo.
Your backup singers?
What? Isn't that the...
Oui. They are the Wiggly Turtle Tubies.
The Wiggly Turtle Tubies? They look taller on TV.
So do you, Tomato!
But really, this is Larry's gig. I can't just...
This show must go on, monsieur. Quick, that is your cue. Just follow along, you will be fine.
But...
Let's dance, turtle. Aloha, lands. Let's dance, turtle. Dance, dance, dance. Let's dance, turtle. Aloha, lands. Let's dance, turtle. Dance, dance, dance.
Well, I keep a little turtle at my uncle and my aunt's. My Annie's name is Myrtle, and my island turtle's name is Lance. He doesn't wander far, even if he has a chance. He just plays his ukulele, and he does the hula dance. What?
Lance the turtle, aloha Lance. Lance the turtle, dance, dance, dance. Lance the turtle, aloha Lance. Lance the turtle, dance, dance, dance.
He threw a luau barbecue one breezy summer night. Invited all his turtle pals to come and have a weeky bite. The turtle started walking there as Lance began to swing. The one that lived across the street arrived there in the spring. Oh, I get it. Turtles are slow. So it took him a long time. That's pretty good.
Lance the turtle, aloha Lance. Lance the turtle. Dance, dance, dance.
But Lance just kept on cooking. He was grilling full of glee. He was marinating ribs cause he likes syrup with his feta cheese? I'm sorry, I... Lance's purple turtle shell has ketchup if you please. Pineapples are shiny, spotted tiki bumblebees. Oh, man.
Lance the turtle, Aloha, Lance. Lance the Turtle.
Oh, wait a minute. Hey, guys, I don't think this is right. It doesn't make any sense.
It works for us.
But...
Zizoon!
There are luscious chocolate fingers spinning slowly in the school. Malay Kalikimaka. Fluffy bunnies driving in the pool. Larry! A thousand igloos wax the beach. Spray luggage in the tree. Raining puppies. Flying clown. Flossing Puna Haley. Ow! Oh, forget it.
Woohoo! La Paca Sneezy's coconut! Tahiti yo-yo leg! White meanie with spaghetti sauce! Don't make the fuzzy parrot beg!
Paper plastic porcupine! The horsey makes his bed! The hoo-mahoo manuku nuku abwa I was in bed!
Lance the Turtle! Aloha, Lance!
This has been Ukulele Karaoke with Bob. Tune in next time when Bob says...
I'll be in my dressing room.
Dance, dance, dance!
And now it's time for The Blues with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings the blues.
Hey, everybody. I'm gonna lay down some blues. All sunshine and roses, no rain came my way. I said, all sunshine and roses, no rain came my way. Mm-mm. My dad bought me ice cream. Oh, happy, 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 happy day. I ate up that ice cream. Got some on my face. That's right, right on my face. I said, I ate up that ice cream. Got some on my face. Got some on the table. Oh, happy, sticky, happy, sticky, happy, happy, sticky, happy place.
Hey, man, what you doing?
I'm singing the blues.
Oh, man, the blues is for singing when you feel sad.
But I don't feel sad.
Man, you got no business singing the blues. Here, let me help you out. Take this.
Cool, ice cream. Thanks.
Now give me back that ice cream.
You took my ice cream, you took it from me. You took my ice cream, you took it away from me.
Oh yeah, now you're getting it. Now listen up.
But I'm still not sad. I'll just have a cookie.
No, 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 man. You almost had it. Come on, like this. You took away my ice cream. You took it away from me. My sweet creamy ice cream. I don't care about no cooking. Woo! Now try it again.
My cookies and ice cream. They both gone away.
That's right. Feel it.
My cookies and ice cream, they both gone away.
Oh, sweet, man. Sweet.
But that don't bother me none. I got me my freshly baked strudel.
What? Strudel? Man, you can't say strudel in the blues. That don't even rhyme.
Well, what about poodle? Because I got a poodle.
Oh, no, don't tell me you're going to eat that poodle.
No, I'm just going to pet him. Petting poodles makes me happy.
Sorry, man. You way too happy to sing the blues.
Hello? Would you like to polka?
Sure. Don't got no ice cream, no cookies, no strudel. Don't got no ice cream, no cookies, no strudel. But I'm yodel lady, yodel lady, yodel lady happy. Just here with my poodle. That's right. Oh yeah, I'm yodel lady, yodel lady, yodel lady happy. Just me and my poodle.
This has been The Blues with Len. Tune in next time to... Oh, never mind.
Larry's not likely to be singing the blues again anytime soon.
One day, while he was waiting for the trolley, he had a hat,
my high silk hat.
He wore it high upon his head so proudly, a beautiful hat,
my high silk hat.
A hat like this just makes him feel so grandly. Now fancy this, and fancy that. The splendor of this hat in all its majesty.
Like a king in a royal cap. I feel so swell and handsome in my hat. I bet that others wish they had. In fact,
a hat is this, a hat is that, a hat so fine, a high so
hat. Oh, Mr. Art Bugatti, now what do you think of that?
Now his hat was not all he wore so proudly. I must, in fact, share more than that. For upon his lap there sat a treat so fondly of chocolate this
and chocolate that.
Deliciousness that makes him feel so dandy. A chocolate bliss,
a chocolate snack.
Conventions such as these are more than candy. Someone might buy a box of that.
I have my chocolate placed upon my lap. I feel so good, you just cannot top that. I have my snack, a chocolate pack of chocolate bits and chocolate that. Oh golly, Mr. Nezzer, now what do you think of that?
Upon his hat
and sharp as snap.
So beneath his hat he thought and pondered,
what should I do to save my hat?
He thought and contemplated as he perspired beneath his hat.
Upon his hat
he feared his chocolate treats would soon retire into a pool
and sharp as that.
I won't feel grand if I take off my hat. The sun's getting hot. My hat, it might go flat, and my sweets will melt like that. Oh, hurry, Mr. Trolley, before my dapperness goes flat.
He decided to forego his looks so dashing to save his hat
and little snack.
So he placed the treats upon the seat beside him
and put his hat on top of that.
Oh, please,
oh, please, oh, please.
Don't anybody sit close to me. Upon my hat.
Upon my hat.
If all of you could be so kindly and just stand back away from my snack. A great big squash just sat upon my hat. A great big squash just squished my hat real flat. He squashed my hat, he made it flat, he squished my snack. Oh, what a bat! Oh, tell me anybody, now what do you think of that?
A great big squash just sat upon my hat. A great big, you know, the squash squished his hat real flat. He squashed his hat, he made it flat, he squished his hat. Oh, what a bat!
Oh, golly! What's your name?
They've never given me a name. I've been around since show one, and I still don't have a name.
Now, what do you think of that?
One day, while talking with Dr. Archibald, Larry confronts one of his deepest fears.
If my lips ever left my mouth, packed a bag and headed south, that'd be too bad. I'd be so sad.
I see, that'd be too bad. You'd be so sad.
That'd be too bad.
Alrighty.
If my lips said adios, I don't like you, I think you're gross. That'd be too bad. I might get mad.
That'd be too bad. You might get mad.
That'd be too bad.
Fascinating.
If my lips moved toodaloof, left a mess and took my tooth, that'd be too bad. I'd call my dad.
Oh, dear. That'd be too bad. You'd call your dad.
That'd be too bad.
Hold it. Did you say your father? Fascinating! So what you're saying is, if your lips left you...
That'd be too bad, I'd be so sad, I might get mad, I'd call my dad, that'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
Why?
Cause I love my lips. Beedly bap bop beedly bop boo, ebi da bop boo, ba da boo bow. Yabba da bop a dee ba bop boom bum, beedly bop bop a dow. Yabba da bop a bop a bop a bop a bop a bop.
My, this is more serious than I thought. Larry, what do you see here?
That looks like a lip.
What about this?
It's a lip.
And this?
It's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 lip.
Larry, tell me about your childhood.
When I was just 2 years old, I left my lips out in the cold and they turned blue. What could I do?
Oh dear, they turn blue, what could you do?
Oh, they turn blue.
I see.
On the day I got my tooth, I had to kiss my great aunt Ruth. She had a beard, and it felt weird.
My, my, she had a beard and it felt weird?
She had a beard.
Oh.
10 days after I turned 8, got my lips stuck in a gate. My friends all laughed, and I just stood there until the fire department came and broke the lock with the crowbar, and I had to spend the next 6 weeks in lip rehab with this kid named Oscar who got stung by a bee right on the lip, and we couldn't even talk to each other until the 5th week because both of our lips were so swollen, and when he did start speaking, he just spoke Polish, and I only knew like 3 words in Polish, except now I know 4 because Oscar taught me the word for lip, usta.
Your friends all laughed. Usta. How do you spell that?
I don't know.
So what you're saying is that when you were young...
They turned blue, what could I do? She had a beard and it felt weird. My friends all laughed. What's that?
I'm confused.
I love my lips. Boo-da-bop-bee-bop-bee-doo-bop.
Ebi-dee-bop-boo-bee-bop.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Larry say...
Have I ever told you how I feel about my nose?
Oh, look at the time!
Bye, babu, babi, babi.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Today, Larry and Bob are on a photo safari, hot on the trail of a monkey. Or an ape. We don't know which. Hence the song.
If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. Even if it has a monkey kind of shape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey.
Let's see if we can catch it on the tape.
You can very plainly see if it's a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
Look, there it goes, there it goes. I don't know, I can't tell if it's a monkey or an ape. It's very simple, Bob.
If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
Larry, I'm not so sure.
Ooga booga, isn't that a monkey?
Booga wooga, maybe it's an ape.
If it's a nickel or a salad or a pillow, if it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
If it doesn't have a tail...
Not a monkey.
Are you sure that's what you really mean to say? A camera has no tail.
It's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
Huh, I think there's something wrong with your logic, Larry.
Well, Bob, the lady at the zoo said it. And who am I to tell her that she's wrong? If there's a tail, it's a monkey. No tail, ape. It's easy.
But Larry, a kite has a tail.
Then it's a monkey.
A comet has a tail.
It's a monkey.
A bubble doesn't.
Then it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey.
It's an ape?
Exactly. I knew you'd catch on.
Larry, we might need to talk about this. I don't think the lady at the zoo meant...
Shh. Look, there it goes in the trees. Follow me. It's gotta be a monkey or an ape. I can't believe it's true. All this time I've searched for you. Snap the picture, take the shot. We're among the lucky few. We finally did it, photographer. We've discovered what we're after. Let me look. Is it an ape?
Larry, this is a disaster.
It's a monkey.
Larry, that's a cow, not
that
a...
That was exhilarating. Let's find more. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. Even if it has a monkey kind of shape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Bob say...
Larry, you don't have a tail.
I don't?
Nope, and neither do I.
I wouldn't be so sure about that, Bob.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Elves, the part of the show where Iricorn comes out and sings a silly song for elves.
I asked my baby elf, a couple questions about myself. If I was handsome, if I was nice, I was looking for her advice. She looked at me and shook her head, and this is what she said. When I go walking all by myself, I'm busy thinking about my elf. I keep her picture upon my shelf. I'm always dreaming about my elf. I won't forget the way that she says those words to me.
What are you doing? Ouch! Hey!
I knew it! I knew it!
What?
You should be ashamed of yourself! You're no elf! You're an elvish impersonator! You second me, deceitful one!
Oh, right. Like you're a real elf? Give the guard a bow and arrow and he's a real elf!
This has been Silly Songs for Elves.
Behold, Legolam! Have at thee! My bow shall sing with your pompadour!
Don't you point that thing at me! Help!
Now, kids, we're gonna sing along with one of my favorite songs, the Bunny Song.
Monsieur Bob, we're not supposed to sing the Bunny Song.
Oh, thank you for pointing that out, Jean-Claude. But this is the new and improved Bunny Song. This is the one we're supposed to sing.
I see.
The bunny, whoa, I ate the bunny. I didn't eat my soup or my bread, just the bunny. The bunny, the bunny, oh, I love the bunny. But now I feel sick in the head from the bunny. I didn't eat my salad, I didn't eat my steak. I had too much candy, got a tummy ache. I need to eat good food to help me to grow. I'll obey my mama, 'cause she loves me so. Yeah, I'll go to church, and I'll go to school. That stuff is important, and I ain't no fool.
I don't want no pickles, I don't want no honey, I just want a plate and a fork and a bunny.
No, girl. No, that's wrong. Listen here, girls. Oh, no. The bunny, the bunny, whoa, I ate the bunny. I didn't eat my soup or my bread, just the bunny. The bunny, the bunny, oh, I love the bunny. But now I feel sick.
Next up on Veggie Shopping Network.
pets.
Welcome, viewers. What comes next? A pair of pants with stripes or checks? Dig in your wallet, dump out your purse. Who'll be the one to buy the first pair?
You can wear them if you're big, you can wear them if you're small. They're pants if you're short, and shorts if you're tall. You can wear them in the spring, you can wear them in the fall. They're pants if you're short, and shorts if you're tall.
So 5 so far, down to 20.
Look what you get for a little bit of money. Down to your feet and up to your tummy. If you buy right now tonight, we'll throw in a set of Ginsu knives. A pair of pants could change your life. One easy payment, $9.95. See the tag on the back, one size fits all.
They're pants if you're short,
and shorts if you're tall. You can wear them to the farm, you can wear them to the mall.
They're pants if you're short,
and shorts if you're tall.
16 more, we're down to 4.
You can't buy these in any store. They're just like your granddaddy wore. Six legs, less than a squid. It's a verb for a dog and a noun for a kid. With a pair of pants, you're not alone. You can dance with your pants till the cows come home. This pair of pants will win your heart.
We accept most credit cards.
A stretchy waist elastic band makes these your buffet-eating pants.
Trouser slacks are corduroys. Pants bestow a special joy. As seen on the screen of your TV, these pants can hide unsightly knees.
This pair is made of high-grade vinyl.
Don't hesitate, all sales are vital.
To summarize, you might recall their pants if you're short and shorts if you're tall.
4, 3, 2, 1, going, 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 done!
We're out of pants, we gotta run!
Pants!
You've got some skinny legs.
Pants!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Joining Larry are Pa Grape and Mr. Lunt, who together make up the infamous gang of scallywags, the pirates who don't do anything.
We are the pirates who don't do anything. We just stay home and lie around. And if you ask us to do anything,
we don't do anything.
Well, I've never been to Greenland, and I've never been to Denver, and I've never buried treasure in St. Louis or St. Paul, and I've never been to Moscow, and I've never been to Tampa, and I've never been to Boston in the fall.
We're the pirates who don't do anything. We just stay home and lie around. And if you ask us to do anything, we'll just tell you.
We don't do anything. And I never hoist the mainstay, and I never swab the poop deck, and I never veer to starboard, cause I never sail at all. And I've never walked the gangplank, and I've never owned that parrot, and I've never been to Boston in the fall.
We're the pirates who don't do anything. We just stay home and lie around. And if you ask us to do anything, we'll just tell you.
We don't do anything.
Well, I've never plucked a rooster, and I'm not too good at ping pong, and I've never thrown my mashed potatoes up against the wall, and I've never kissed a chipmunk, and I've never gotten head lice, and I've never been to Boston in the fall.
Huh? What are you talking about? What's a rooster and mashed potatoes have to do with being a pirate?
Hey, that's right. We're supposed to sing about piratey things.
And who's ever kissed a chipmunk? That's just nonsense. Why even bring it up? Am I right? What do you think?
I think you look like Captain Crunch.
Huh? No, I don't.
Do too.
Do not.
You're making me hungry.
That's it. You're walking the plank.
Says who?
Says the cabin. That's who?
Oh, yeah? Aye, aye, Captain Crunch.
Burg!
Yikes!
And I've never licked a spark plug, and I've never sniffed a stink bug, and I've never painted daisies on a big red rubber ball, and I've never bathed in yogurt, and I don't look good in leggings.
You just don't get it.
And we've never been to Boston in the fall.
Pass the chips. Who's got the remote control?
Here it is. Time for Geraldo.
It's definitely time for Wapna.
Oh, I don't like this show.
Hey, look! I found a quarter!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song.
Got the munchies on that fateful night, around 8 o'clock. So I phoned in a pizza for delivery. But I had a feeling that something wasn't right, cause I waited for hours and no pizza. I set the table with a paper plate. How would I know that it'd be late? It's taken so long, where could it be? Had a 30-minute guarantee. Pizza Angel, please come to me. Tomato sauce and cheese so gooey. Pizza Angel, I'm on my knees. You're my number one pie from Sicily. Did it get lost? Did they just forget? Should I have ordered on the internet? Ready for dinner? Now I'm not so sure. I think my soda's room temperature. Pizza Angel, please come to me. Tomato sauce and cheese so gooey. Pizza Angel, I'm on my knees. And don't forget to add my favorite. Chicago style, going crazy while I paced the floor. Then my heart skipped when I heard the door. Opened the door in expectation, but it was the saddest sight I ever saw. I could still smell the sweet aroma of deep dish goodness, but the box was empty.
Your house number was broken, so I couldn't find you. I was getting kind of hungry, so I ate your pizza. Sorry about that. You don't need to tip me or anything.
Please come to me. Tomato sauce and cheese so gooey. Pizza Angel, I'm on my knees. You'll live forever in my bed. Pizza Angel, please come to me. Tomato sauce and cheese so gooey. Pizza Angel, I'm on my knees. I will miss you for eternity.
I'll never forget you, Pizza Angel.
And now it's time for Schoolhouse Polka with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a schoolhouse polka.
Weather, 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 whether you like it or not. Weather, 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 weather is cold, warm, and hot. Two, 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 my favorite toys. I'm bringing two, 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 a place the first one enjoys, and I like it too. Homophones, homophones, where the crews come cruising down the plain. Homophones, homophones, I need my Native Biscuits plain. I know a pear, 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 pear with a pair of really soft shoes. He wears in the pear, 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 bushes that easily bruise. I planted rose, 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 rose of a horribly bad smelling rose. Now no one knows, 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 knows if the scent will be leaving my nose, but most likely no. Oh, homophones, homophones, where the toads are towed out on the plain. Homophones, homophones, I need my Native Biscuits plain.
This has been Schoolhouse Polka with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Larry sing.
What happened to my preposition? I took it on an expedition, put it by the thing I keep my fish in. Got infected with a skin condition.
And?
I'm a pronoun, they're a pronoun, he's a pronoun, she's a pronoun. Would you like to be a pronoun too?
And?
It was the biggest, bluest, cleanest, brightest, quickest, newest, roundest, nicest, softest, tallest, toughest, lightest, smoothest, kindest, flattest, tightest, most amazing adjective I'd ever seen.
And?
I'm done.
Interjections? Adverbs?
No.
Alrighty.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Bob the Tomato, unable to sneeze, visits the sneeze doctor.
Please, can someone help me? I need to sneeze.
Wait for the sneeze doctor. Just take a seat. He'll be right with you.
Sneeze if you have to. Sneeze if you need to. Don't hold it in. Just be sure that you cover your mouth with a tissue. I will assist you. Sneeze all your troubles away. Add up to 150 miles an hour.
Interesting fact. The average sneeze travels at a rate of 100 miles an hour. In 2003, Dirk Everett of Grünholz, Germany, clocked in at 150. Way to go, Dirk!
Dunker.
I think I have a remedy, perhaps in my potpourri. I bought it from a merchant in Spain. For ultimate sneeze satisfaction, try allergic reaction. Take a deep breath, if it helps, you can squint at the sun. Or here's some pepper. Let's see. I know! I can try this feather! Don't be afraid! Set it free! Let it go! 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 Go, 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 go!
Interesting fact. The photic sneeze reflex, or sneezing when exposed to bright light, is a genetic trait found in 25% of the population, including Dirk.
Spain!
Gesundheit. Which, interestingly, means good health in German.
Ja!
Sneeze if you have to. Sneeze if you need to.
This has been Silly Songs with Fanny. Tune in next time to hear Dirk say,
Ich bin ein Schneezer.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Larry the Cucumber presents in a sequential image stereophonic multimedia event, the Song of the Saboo.
A song about a little boy and his saboos. A song about a little boy and his three saboos. The little boy who had a sick saboo, a sad saboo, and a mute saboo. And also a hippo. This is me at the airport. This is my Aunt Ruth. This is me at a bullfight. This is me fighting a bull.
Ooh.
This is me and the bull.
Ah!
This is me and the bull, and I think that's the bull's cousin. He's a Sabu.
Hold it! You call this a multimedia event? This is a slide projector and a bedsheet! And what on earth is a Sabu, anyway?
It's kind of like a cow. See?
Yes. Well, very good. This could be interesting. Carry on.
Sabu. Sing it with me. Sabu.
Sabu.
Boy is riding with Sabu.
Boy is riding with Sabu.
Into town in his canoe.
Into town in his canoe.
Six Sabu is rowing and sneezing. Achoo moo moo, achoo moo moo, achoo moo moo, achoo moo 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 moo.
Achoo moo moo, 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 achoo moo moo moo.
Hippo chewing on bamboo.
Hippo chewing on bamboo.
Kissy boy and three Sabu.
Kissy boy and three Sabu.
Sad Sabu is rowing and crying. Boo moo moo, boo moo moo, boo moo moo, boo moo 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 moo.
Injured? Why is the sad Sabu sad? Is the canoe wood or aluminum? This is quite disappointing. I'm going to have to speak to Bob about this.
Oh, look! A Sabu!
Sabu!
No, wait. That's a water buffalo.
No more song about Sabu. Need another verse or two. Audience is standing and leaving. Bye-bye, moo, bye-bye, moo.
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. So without further ado, Silly Songs with Larry.
The Water Buffalo Song.
Everybody's got a water buffalo. Yours is fast, but mine is slow. Oh, where'd we get them? I don't know. But everybody's got a water buffalo. I took my buffalo to the store. Got his head stuck in the door. Spilled some lima beans on the floor. Oh, everybody got a...
Stop right this instant. What do you think you're doing? You can't say everyone's got a water buffalo and everyone does not have a water buffalo. We're going to get nasty letters saying, where's my water buffalo? Why don't I have a water buffalo? And are you prepared to deal with that? I don't think so. Just stop being so silly.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Larry sing.
Everybody's got a baby kangaroo. Yours is pink, but mine is blue. Hers was
And now it's time for Obscure Broadway Show Tunes with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings an obscure Broadway show tune. Without further ado, from the unknown musical Office Supplies, the heart-rending love song, Where Have All the Staplers Gone?
We don't have much time before the big meeting.
No. No, we don't.
Have you seen the scissors, miss?
They're in the bottom drawer.
I tried that drawer, but they're there no more.
That's odd.
I know, I thought for sure.
Have you seen the masking tape?
It's right next to the phone.
How
That's what I thought, but now it's not. I guess I should have known.
Where have all the staplers gone? What happened to our paper clips?
The ballpoint pens are gone again.
They're gone again. The stick-it pads have lost their stick.
Do you remember when
rubber bands were in their place?
They're in the middle drawer.
Light bulbs easy to replace.
Yes,
there were always more
reams of paper raining down.
Legal pads aplenty.
Highlighters in every hue.
I remember.
Never less than. Where have all the staplers gone? What happened to our paper clips?
The ballpoint pens are gone again.
We've run out of packing slips.
Someday my prints will come.
Please replace the toner.
Someday we'll find more of
our vanilla folders. Where's the printer cable?
Someday we'll find more of
adhesive shipping labels.
Show Tunes with Lead. Tune in for Act 2, Revenge of the Staplers.
There lived a man so long ago, his memories but faint. Was not admired,
did not inspire,
like president or saint. But people came from far and near with their afflicted pets for a special cure.
They knew for sure
wouldn't come from other vets. Whoa!
This is a song for your poor sick penguin. He's got a fever and his toes are blue. But if I sing to your poor sick penguin, he will feel better in a day or two.
He's gone a little loopy, in case you haven't heard. Here's a couple penicillin for your sickly arctic void.
No skeptic could explain just how, nor could one of three, but the wondrous deeds that went on in that little alpine hut. Some would stand in silence while some just scratched their scalps for the curious ways of the yodeling veterinarian of the Alps. Whoa!
Good news on the penguin, Doc! He's up and kicking!
This is a song for your pregnant kitty. She's looking nauseous and a weak path too. But if I think to your pregnant kitty, she will feel better in a day or two. Yule, 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 yule.
Jump in your car, drive into the city, buy a jug of milk for your nauseated kitty.
The practice grew, their profits flew, until one fateful day, when the nurse who did assist the doc asked for a raise in pay. The doctor pondered this a while, sat back and scratched his scalp, then said,
"No way, Jose!"
To the nurse of the yodeling veteran.
Good news on the kitty, Doc. She's feeling great. 6 kittens. Main one after you.
This is a song for your bear trap teddy. He looks uncomfy. Think I'd be too. But if I think to your bear trap teddy, he will feel better in a day or two.
Oh yeah, that'll work. He's good.
No way! This should work!
Now the moral of our story, it's the point we hope we've made.
When you go a little loopy, better keep your nurse well paid.
Whoa! Some would stand in silence while some just scratch their scalps. For the curious ways of the yodeling veterinarian of the